Greetings, and here we are in LGR once again with one of my favorite things. We are unboxing yet another inbox IBM PC. This one in particular being the IBM PC 5140, otherwise known as the PC Convertible. It was first released in 1986 for about $2,000, although I think this particular configuration with all this stuff cost a little bit more. And this was IBM's first laptop computer. Now, they had portables before this and some other various PC kind of spin-offs, you know, PC Junior and such. But this was the first one to come as close to what we would call a laptop computer nowadays. Of course, there's a ton of history and a bunch of things that go into this whole system and how it works and what it was for and what came before it and after it. And, you know, all these kind of things that I want to do in a later video. But just for today, because I am working on some larger projects like that, I do want to just talk about this in an unboxing form and get this thing opened up because I found this some time ago, actually. I've had it sitting around for a while and just been waiting for an opportunity to dive into it and see what's in here because, yeah, it is new in the box, or at least as close to it as I could find. It's definitely been opened up at one point or another, but as far as I know, it's never actually been powered on. So yeah, we'll go ahead and get straight to it. We're gonna start with this box here. We've got a power supply, and yes, there is a printer with this thing, and this is one of the most interesting aspects of a computer. We'll get to that. But yeah, for now, let's open up this new-ish old stock machine and set it up. I think actually this was the first IBM computer to officially come with a 3.5-inch disk drive. So that's another notable thing. There's a lot of notable things. And like I said, we'll be doing like a more retrospective video in the future. For now, I just want to see what the experience was like getting one of these from the shops back in the day. Yeah, like I said, the seller did open it up and do some other packaging. Because yeah, I guess it was missing the original styrofoam inserts. So yeah, that's unfortunate, but all right, here we go. I got one of those nice familiar chunky IBM PC power cables. I've got an add-on card of some kind here and an IBM box. What is this? It's like a RAM upgrade. So there is an IBM battery pack. Part number 2684331. All right, looks like we have some instructions here for installing that RAM card. That's nice. Oh yeah, the delightful guide to operations here. It's a little different design than the other ones that I've unboxed. Still, very nice bit of IBM spiral-bound documentation. And yes, here's the IBM PC Convertible startup diskette. Oh yeah, I love this stuff. And I got a packet of, something. Okay, so interesting little registration card here. You got a nice little adhesive bit that you can remove and stick it together to, yeah, let IBM know how much money you make and stuff. And looks like a little quick setup guide. Yeah, this little word-free, language-free thing for, yeah, starting it up. Basically, insert the disk and power it on and stuff. Oh, yes. I love when computers come with this, especially IBM's. It's just nice, classy, stationary, and typed out welcome letter here. And thank you for purchasing a personal computer from IBM. Yeah, pretty standard stuff being like, you know, what is this though? What is that? Can you see that? Yeah, if I shine the light through it, it says writing and something else right there. Oh, this fell out too. License agreement, whatever. I sense DOS. Oh, now that is delightful. We have a still sealed DOS version 3.20, and this is IBM PC DOS, not Microsoft DOS. I mean, it's, you know, still by Microsoft, of course, but yeah, this is specifically for IBM PC Convertibles. Interesting, so that means it probably, yeah, it doesn't come with any 5.25-inch disks. And just by comparison here, here's my normal copy that I use of DOS version 3.3. And you can see on the back there that it mentions that it has, of course, 5.25-inch disks, but Also, you know, all these other computers supported. I mean, I'm assuming this will support whatever computer as well. It's just, it's not made for them exactly. Okay, time for the main event. Oh, that's nice. It's still in some kind of a shrink wrap deal here. So I don't know if it came like this from the factory, but I mean, either way, it looks immaculate under that plastic, which is nice because I actually used to have a PC 5140 years ago, and it was in just the worst condition that I never did a video on it. It just needed too much work. So this is lovely. All right, this is potentially the first time this has been opened. Ooh, that's some quality plastic, man. Yeah, that smells fresh. Oh, wow. Oh, there's a little tiny little broken chip of something there. So I got knocked around at some point. Seems like there's just like some fragile bits of plastic here where this really high quality metal handle goes into place. It just sort of bumps up against that. Anyway. Oh, ho, ho, ho. And there we go. This is the IBM PC Convertible. And it's awesome. Look at that. You don't see these too often. At least I don't. Like the inserts for the little 3.5-inch drives. Typically that's only a 5.25-inch thing. But these, that's awesome. Wow, and they're nicely shaped and everything. It's really cool. So yeah. I see like a film or something on here. I don't know if that comes off or what. Or if that's like inside, hopefully it's not like coming apart in there or something. I don't know. Like I said, the seller said they'd never turned it on before. So who knows? Who knows what's going on here? Yeah, it should go like that because that's where the little latch goes. So get that reattached real quick. Yeah, just a little bit of Gorilla Gel should help. Being that this is an actual functional latch piece though. I want to be careful in the future for sure. All right, can let that dry. But as you can see here, it's just a sort of mechanism where the whole thing lifts up like that and brings up the disk drives and everything. I'm not gonna latch it fully because it's still drying that little part, but yeah, it's just a really cool design, I think. And this whole screen actually comes off. Let's see, where is it? There it is, like this. So here's the convertible aspect of this thing. So you could actually take this off and there was a monitor mount. You might have seen it on the box earlier. And you could put like a full CRT in here and, you know, there you go. You've got this neat looking little thing. Almost looks like a Tandy 1000 HX or something here. A little smaller, narrower anyway. You know, no numpad, but still very, very nice keys. I mean, oh, it's not exactly like a clicky keyboard, but pretty quality. There's just something about the way these old keyboards smell, especially when they've been sealed up like that, like new. I mean, because it seriously still smells new. You know, it's a slight new car smell. It's wonderful. It's probably just toxic plastic and paint, though. Okay, and put that over there for now. And let's get those other two things opened up because, of course, gotta have some power. That old scotch tape, it's so yellow now. And here we go, this is almost PC Junior-like, but thankfully not as like weird proprietary crap going on. But yeah, just a nice little brick here. I think it's a 15 volt, 2.7 amp. Yeah, and that just goes in the side right here now.
Should. There it is.
And look at that. It's even got a little teeny little orange power button instead of, you know, the big red orange switch that the PCs typically had. But yeah, look at that. It's still orange, red, whatever. And lastly, this is one of the things that has always interested me about this machine, and that is the PC convertible printer. Another convertible aspect. You know, they call this the convertible instead of just like a portable or whatever for multiple reasons. And this is one of those reasons. Oh man, look at this little guy. A little tiny ink ribbon cartridge. Now this is pristine. Ah, okay. Got a little feeder tray here. Yeah, man. So this is a, it's like a full dot matrix printer, and it's just in a nice little compact unit. Look at that. The PC convertible printer. I love all the little original inserts and stuff. Oh. So the way this works, you've got a little plastic piece that comes off the back here. And this, it just connects in place, almost like a PC Junior sidecar, but this is, you know, a laptop computer. Okay, I gotta move the little latch there. Okay, there we go. And once that's in place, yeah, you have a computer that is really, really long. It just becomes this absurd deal when you start adding these expansions on the back. But the fact that you can have a laptop with a built-in printer is just great. And of course, there were other laptops later on that had built-in printers, and portables before and after this with built-in printers. It's not the only thing that does anything like this, but it's one of the coolest, I think, just in terms of its like overall form factor and design. And I don't know, I just think this looks really great as well, just from a design perspective. I mean, and it should, considering this was an industrial design by Richard Sapper. Well, let's go ahead and get DOS going on this thing and see what it can do really quick. I've been itching to try one of these that actually works properly. Time for some of that DOS. I've never actually had this version of DOS brand new like this. Ooh. Sorry, I know my like smelling and stuff of these things can get creepy for some people, but man, this is just still so special to me. Look at all this. Okay, you got some things here. Yours free, the directory. I've showed the actual directory in one of my other unboxings. I'm gonna read this first, installing DOS. Got a nice little reference card here for a lot of your most common DOS commands. Well, a lot of these are not common at all, but it has them anyway, because IBM. So yeah, DOS reference. Oh, it's got like nice little color things going on. I dig that. Look at the little DOS bird or whatever. What is that guy? Doesn't actually say who he is. Just, he's all through here though. There's an update package for the PC convertible itself. That's nice. 10 pages, 5 sheets, and a label. DOS also comes on 2 diskettes. Both diskettes are in the back of the DOS reference in a plastic. They were really adamant about you keeping that information in mind, I guess, because they give you an entirely separate label to place on here to remind you about that. But yeah, apparently there's a couple little updates in here for the convertible itself. So yeah, I mean, otherwise it's just generic DOS 3.2 here, but cool. Nice that it came with that. Here we go, PC DOS version 3.21. Now keep that out, because we're gonna be using that. That's a lot of DOS. Okay, let's get this thing started up. Okay, just gonna try it unexpanded in its lovely original form for now. Got everything plugged in, so let's power it on and see what happens. Ooh, doing the RAM check there. Should have 256K by default. Nice. And there we go. I got the little disk insert graphic there. Very IBM PS2 like. But yeah, this is, sorry, it's kind of hard to see. I mean, it's just always gonna be hard to see. This screen is never good, even when it's brand new. Non-system disk, the heck? That's definitely a system disk, yo. There we go. All right, so asking for the current date, which is... All right, and there we go. We've got DOS version 3.2, and yeah, unfortunately it does look like there is a bit of a line through the display there. That's unfortunate, but so it goes. To be honest, I didn't buy this to use very much. Mostly I just want to do a video on like the history of it and, you know, just kind of show it in action and such, because it's just a fascinating machine. If I really wanted to use an IBM PC, I'd use any number of my dozens of other ones that I have, because they're all gonna be better than this. But it's just the fact that its form factor and design and everything is just so friggin' cool to me. So yeah, if I really wanted to use this better, I can, you know, easily swap out this screen for probably, I think my other screen actually looked a little better than this. So I don't know. There's extra parts and stuff online. We'll see what happens when I get around to it. But yeah, got donkey.bass, classic. Device IO error.
Well, there may be some issues with this drive. Maybe it just needs to be cleaned, or maybe it's a belt issue or something. We'll see.
I still have the other one, so if I really need to like start swapping out some parts and whatnot, because, you know, it's always a thing. It seems like. Let's try the other drive. Well, I got a directory perfectly the first time there.
Let's run that donkey.
All right, well, I opened up that perfectly too. So, seems the B drive is in better shape. Best game Microsoft ever made.
Yeah, that's the IBM PC convertible.
Yeah, working nicely for the most part. Unfortunate with that little line through the screen, and of course the A drive needs a bit of attention. And this little thing is a bit weird, and there's a slight bit of film or something coming off around the edges of the screen. Okay, so maybe this is not as brand new as I hoped it would be. I mean, granted, it was never sold as like brand new. It was, you know, new old stock, so you never know how these things have held up being in storage for over 30 years, you know? Always a complete and total crapshoot. So, yeah, let's see if it boots again. Yeah, no. It is intermittent at best when it comes to that A drive, for sure. So, I'll take that apart and see what's going on with it, and then hopefully get this thing all nice and working so I can show it off in another video and do, like, a proper retrospective with the printer. You know, because seriously, that printer is the coolest thing. So, yeah, we'll get to that at some point. But anyway, thank you very much for watching this video, a bit of filler while I'm working on, you know, more involved videos of things that actually work. So, yeah, that's about it for this. If you'd like to see some other episodes like it, I've done quite a few IBM unboxings at this point, and, you know, stuff like this. This is what I do here on LGR every single week. And as always, thank you very much for watching.